Good afternoon, everyone. This is Kevin Gianni and
Amory Gianni.
And today is Friday, and today we are naming. What are we naming? The men and
gotta look. The most influential health people.
The most influential men and women in 2011.
I memorized my part, but that wasn't.
In health, I know. I threw you a loop. Threw you for a loop. And so today we've worked really hard to put this list together, and it was going to be two people, but.
Mm-hmm. We couldn't decide. So we chose four.
That's four. Sorry. We tried so hard to make it right, but to make it two, but we just couldn't narrow it down because each one was so specific for the particular reasons why we wanted to choose them. We decided that we would have to do four. And, you know, really, the people that we named before the last 2 days, you know, they were probably right up there too. Mm-hmm. So it's like all of them. Mm-hmm. You know, building a top 10 list is very difficult, somewhat subjective as well. We were listening on NPR yesterday, on the way down to New Jersey. We're in New Jersey now, as you can tell, the background's changed. The hat hasn't, but the background has. And there was a film critic from, I think, Dallas, one of the Dallas newspapers, and he was saying that, you know, top 10 lists are subjective. They're just what I want people to see. Mm-hmm. Totally. And I was like, yeah, all right. We tried to be a little more objective than that, but.
And he also said it always ends up, like if he's doing a top 10 movie list or something, it always ends up the movies that came out in like October and November that are on there because they're like most, yeah. they're still in his head.
They're on top of mind. So anyway, and you know, we probably should have dressed up for this event.
Like tuxedo? Dress up?
Yeah, why not?
Gown?
Do you have my tuxedo? Where is it?
You don't own a tuxedo.
I had one. What happened to it?
I've never seen one.
Oh, no. Or maybe we should have had streamers or like noisemakers.
We should have.
Yeah, hats.
There's a lot of things
we just have a hat.
We should be doing.
There's a lot of things, yeah. A lot of things we should be doing. Anyway, we're not going to take any more of your time battling back and forth about whether we should be dressed up or not. You want to get started?
Yeah.
All right. Let's do it. Drum roll, please.
Drum roll.
What was your drum roll last time? With a xylophone. All right, so here we go. Emery's got the drum roll. We're going to do...
I'm going to start with the female.
Okay.
Little Lady Love here.
Little Lady Love.
Robin O'Brien with her work with GMOs. If you guys haven't seen any of her work, I would go on to TED Talks and listen to one of the talks that she did. She's just doing a lot out there with her kids and tells her story, and it's awesome. So you really wanted to showcase her.
Yeah, and Robin O'Brien, I mean, obviously you guys can tell GMOs are on the top of our mind right now, and we think they should be because, you know, a lot of they're not the most popular posts when we post them. I don't necessarily care if they're the most popular or not. I think they're actually one of the most important, so it's my job to promote important things. And, you know, GMOs, if GMOs continue to be the way that they are now, they're going to change the human existence for a long period of time, and not for the positive. So that's something to be very aware about. It. If you're not interested in it, please, I would encourage you to become more educated and more interested in it. Get Jeffrey Smith's book, Just Seeds of Deception. Learn about it, and you will become very interested, if not scared. So something that that really should be knowing more about. So, number two.
The next two, again,
it's kind of like a couple.
Yeah, kind of like a couple.
But not really a couple.
Not really a couple. Definitely subjective on our part because it's something that we're just really excited that,
Yeah, I'll explain it. Yeah. So here we go. Number two and number three together. I have a very, can you do three like this very easily? Look at that.
Yeah.
How do you do that? Look at this. I have like a lot of trouble. Like I can't just
I
be like.
This way too.
Three. Yeah, that was easy. Yeah. Or this way. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I saw an NFL ref do this way. Mm-hmm. Is it that hope that's not like some like sign that like that means something
I don't
you
know.
Really mean.
No, two or three.
Right. Anyway, two or three, Dr. Joe McCullough and Dr. Gabriel Cousins. And here's why. Both of them are doing incredible stuff. Dr. Joe McCullough has an incredible health website, produces a lot of great health content for you. Has some high-quality products. Dr. Gabriel Cousins, all the same, and he's also doing some great work with diabetes. So we all know that. They're all, you know, they're both doing incredible things. But the reason why I wanted to recognize them in 2011 is for their contribution to the great health debate. When, in a time when a lot of people are arguing and there's a lot of ego involved, the cooperation, that's the right word, the cooperation between Dr. McCullough and Gabriel to be on that call together, the first call that we did, the first call of the Great Health Debate together, when a lot of other experts were not interested at all in sharing
they knowledge. Even though they were on separate calls, they didn't even want to be on the same night as some people.
Oh, I will never do the Great Health Debate again. I thought it would be a way to forward our knowledge. But Joe and Gabriel did look at it that way, and they were willing to put aside their different opinions about health and diet and forward the discussion. Amazing work. Mm-hmm. Thank you, guys. Awesome work. We really appreciate the two of you and what you've done for the health world, for your patients, your clients, your friends, your family, your readers, and everyone else that you come in contact with. Mm-hmm. You guys are great. So you guys definitely get the award this year, as a team and separately. Mm-hmm. So, and finally, drum roll, please. The last one.
Jamie Oliver, again. And
wasn't popular last year, and I'm sure you guys won't think it's popular this year, but
He has an incredible reach. You know, who else is on TV changing the lunch programs in schools?
Who else?
So he's reaching those people that are watching TV all the time that maybe are not watching our show or, you know, are not in our circle.
Which is a lot of people.
Yeah, which is a whole lot of people. And plus, kind of getting to know his work more and getting to know some other people that have worked with him. He's worked a little bit with Alice Waters and with Ann Cooper, who are also incredible people, and I think they should be on the list.
They should be. And let's add Ann Cooper to the list, too.
Yes, we're adding
Renegade Lunch Lady. You got to check her out. She's
totally
doing great
adding
work.
Her to the list.
Ann Cooper's on the list. We had a great talk. We posted it up, and I'll post maybe that down below. Great talk at the University of Cal, Berkeley. And man, fantastic talk. She's a hip lady. I want to hang out with her.
Yeah, she is. She's a lot of fun, and she's doing incredible work. And you know, and kind of helping Jamie Oliver along too. So I think it's cool.
Yeah, he's on the list too. Incredible reach. No one else out there is on national TV changing the school lunch programs, which I think is bringing awareness to something that needs to be done. And look, I mean, you know, maybe it's not the best way, or, you know, maybe it's not the most optimal thing, but it's better than what is now. And that's always the way that progress happens. You know, you don't go from, you know, completely awful to like the highest of highest extremes in a day or in 6 months when it comes to bureaucracy and policy. It just doesn't happen. Anyone who thinks it's going to happen is foolish. Mm-hmm. So you know, we have to work slowly, move slowly. Over time, things change. And Jamie Oliver is doing that. And I hope that because of it, and I know that because of it, other people are interested in doing it too. And that's caused a wave that is attributed to Jamie Oliver, Ryan Seacrest, who produced that show, mm-hmm. and everyone else who's involved in his team. So we appreciate it. So again, Robin O'Brien, Dr. Joe Mercola, Gabriel Cousins, Jamie Oliver, and now Ann Cooper. And everyone else out there who we love and come in contact with, and our colleagues who are doing a lot of great work. We appreciate all of you and all the work that you've done in 2011. Mm-hmm. We look forward to doing more work with you in 2012. Well, I mean, maybe we'll do some work in the next couple hours. I'm sure we will. But in 2012... And what else?
That's it. Just Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.
Be safe this weekend.
Be safe. Mm-hmm. Have a glass of kombucha.
Mm-hmm. Maybe some chocolate.
Maybe some chocolate. Not too late. It'll keep you up. And we look forward to being with you in 2012. The year of change.
Yes.
The year of change. Not the end of the world.
No.
But the year
There's
of
definitely
change.
Definitely going to be lots of change happening.
Maybe the end of the world as we know it.
Which is kind of a good thing.
That's great. It starts with an earthquake, then hurricanes, then things I'm not afraid. I am a hurricane. Listen to the churn. Kevin Gianni in.
Anne-Marie Gianni.
Totally impromptu. Together we change the health of the world.
One show at a time.
Adios.
It's the end
of the world as we know it. And I feel
fine.
Bum, bum, bum.